हेलो फ्रेंड, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल टेक डब्ल्यू थ्री वेव। दिस इज विजय कुमार। टेक डब्ल्यू थ्री वेव इट इज ए प्लेटफॉर्म वेयर यू कैन लर्न स्टेप बाय स्टेप ऑल अबाउट द सेल्स फोर्स एप्लीकेशन एंड डेवलपमेंट। इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल यू विल बी लर्न अवर फ्रेमवर्क एल डब्ल्यू सी, अपेक्स क्लास ट्रिगर, विजुअल फोर्स एंड मेनी मोर। सो नाउ लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। इन दिस लेसन we will be learn about how to communicate between child to parent component using custom event with object data in LWC. So friends, here we are passing the data from child to parent component. Here we will be use custom event and dispatch event with data in LWC. So this is the syntax of custom event. First we will be create a constructor new, then custom event, in the bracket we will be pass the event name and detail. So in the previous lesson we display the model papa on click button, but don't pass the data and detail, only we have pass event name. But in this lesson we will be pass event name as well as data. Dispatch event syntax are: first pass the event name target, then dispatch event, and in the bracket pass the function. So follow the event conventions. So event name always only string, not uppercase letter, not a space, use only underscore to separate word. That means if you passing the event name, don't use space, don't use uppercase, don't use uppercase. If you want to define event name two word, then use underscore. So first here I will create two components, name as parent custom LWC and child custom LWC. So both of the component I created in the previous lesson. So friends, in this lesson we will be using same component. Then we will be binding child component into the parent component. Here we will be passing the data from child to parent component and will show and hide the model pop-up in LWC. So friends, let's see live demo scenario in below example. In this lesson we created two component, child component and parent component, and passing data using custom event and dispatch event in LWC. So friends, in this lesson we will be passing the data from child to parent component on click button. So on the click button we will be display model pop-up. Model pop-up will create in the child component and button will be created in the parent component. So when we click on the button on parent component, display the model pop-up that is created in the child component, and here we will be passing the data from child to parent as a object format. So friends, now let's jump to my VS Code, where we will see live demo example how to pass data from child to parent using custom event and dispatch event in LWC. So now let's get started. So friends, this is my VS Code. In the previous lesson we have created parent custom LWC and child custom LWC. So in this lesson we are using same LWC component. So friends, in the previous lesson we have display model pop-up. So in the parent component I created a button, and in the child component I created a model pop-up. So whenever click on the button in the parent component, model pop-up will be open. So now let's check. Here you can see, after click the button, model pop-up open, and whenever click on the cancel button, this model pop-up will be closed. Here I am sending the data from child to parent because model pop-up cancel, the cancel button of model pop-up created in the child component, and button that is open the model pop-up created in the parent component. So here I am passing the data from child to parent. So friends, in this lesson we will be use same parent component and child component as well. So in the parent component I created a button, and this is a child component name that is calling in the parent component, and in the child component you can see this is a model pop-up and there is a cancel button. So if you go to the child component JavaScript file, here created a custom event and dispatch event. So friends, in the previous lesson you can see in the custom event I pass only the event name, not passing a detail as a object. So in this lesson we will be use detail. So first put the comma, then curly bracket, and here pass the detail. So first write the detail, colon, here I am passing the message that I want to pass the message from child to parent component. always remember, detail is a standard property if you passing the data from child to parent. Not use another one key property. This is a key property, detail. It is a standard to passing the data from child to parent. So always use detail, then pass the message. So let's suppose I am passing the message, the model pop-up has been closed successfully. The model pop-up closed successfully. In this lesson, I am adding detail. This is a detail, is a standard key property of the LWC. And after this event name, put comma, then use curly bracket. Inside the curly bracket, I am passing the detail colon and pass the message that I want to pass from child to parent. Now save the file. Now go to the parent component LWC. And in the parent component LWC, go to the JavaScript. And here I will be use this detail standard property. So go to parent component JavaScript. Here first I will use event. Then after close the model pop-up, I will be display the message, that is that message coming from the child component JavaScript. So first I will create a local variable and I store the value that is coming from the child. So let's suppose write a message, closed model message. This is a message, closed model message. Now copy and this dot closed model message equal to message will become from detail. So this is a standard key property, copy detail. So here we will pass event.detail, event.detail. Now copy this closed model message, go to the parent component, and after this button is a open model. After the lightning button, I will display a message. So message coming from the child component. So first I will create a p type, then use strong, inside the strong I will pass the message, closed model message, this one. Now save the component. So now I am going to deploy the code on Salesforce. So first deploy the code child component, right click and deploy this code to org. The child component deploy successfully. Now go to the parent component and deploy parent component as well. Parent component also deploy successfully. Now go to the Salesforce. Let me check the scenario. Refresh the page. Refresh two times. And now let me click open model pop-up. Pop-up has been opened. Now after click the cancel button, I am passing the message. Message will be passed. If you go to the child component JavaScript, I am passing the message the model pop-up closed successfully. So in the detail key property, I am passing the message the model pop-up closed successfully. So this message will be displayed on the parent component. So now let's click on the cancel button. After click the cancel button, this message will be displayed on the parent component below the button. So now click here. Message not display. Now let me check the code. So go to the VS Code. This is the parent component JavaScript. So here I make mistake. Here we need to pass event.detail. Event.detail. So this detail keyword passing here. Event.details. Now deploy the parent component once again. Component deploy successfully. Now go to the Salesforce org. Refresh the page. ओपन मॉडल पॉपअप, आफ्टर कैंसिल द बटन द मैसेज विल बी डिस्प्ले बिलो द बटन हियर। नाउ लेट मी क्लिक ऑन द कैंसिल बटन, मैसेज नॉट डिस्प्लेइंग। तो फ्रेंड्स आपने कैंसिल द बटन, मैसेज नॉट डिस्प्लेइंग, लेट मी चेक द वीएस कोड। इफ यू गोइंग टू चाइल्ड कंपोनेंट, देयर इज नॉट डिटेल्स, नॉट यूज डिटेल, ओनली पास द डिटेल, नॉट वीएस। देन कॉपी द डिटेल, गो टू द जावास्क्रिप्ट पैनल कंपोनेंट, देयर वी नीड टू पास द डिटेल। दैट टाइम आई गिव इन मिस्टेक, दैट टाइम आई गिव details, so a standard property of the NWC detail, not details. So remove the edge, copy and pass here and save both of the component and deploy the child component as well. Replace the Salesforce org. Now let me open once again the model pop-up. After cancel button, message will be displayed below the button. So now cancel, you can see the model pop-up close successfully. So this message coming from here, the model pop-up close successfully. So friends, here you can see I am passing the data from child to parent. So this is a detail, this is a standard keyword of the LWC. Now I am passing the data as a object format. So remove this line, and here I am applying curly bracket, it is a object tag. And let's suppose I am passing the message model closed msd message, then colon, and here pass the value. So let's suppose I am passing the value the model pop-up closed successfully and comma, and here I am passing another one keyword, this message will be display welcome to TW3B. So welcome take colon, and here I am passing the message welcome to TW3B, welcome to TW3B from Vijay Kumar. Now save the component JavaScript file. Now this time I am creating a object. In the object I am passing two key and value. So in the parent object JavaScript I will create two variable. First variable is model close message, and second variable is welcome take. So in the close model message, here I will pass close model message equal to event detail dot name of the key. So this is a key, this is a value. Key is a model close message dot this one, then another one keyword is welcome take. So copy and already created this is a local variable, this dot welcome take equal to event dot detail dot this is a keyword welcome take. Then save the file and deploy to Salesforce org. Computer deploy successfully. Now friends, this message I want to display on the HTML, so go to the parent custom LWC. And here I will create two ptag. From in the first ptag I will display modal close message this in the curly bracket pass the variable and copy p tag and paste below and here will be pass welcome tag. Now save the component and deploy to Salesforce app. Component deploy successfully. Now go to the child component and deploy this one again. Component deploy successfully to the Salesforce org. Now let's go on the Salesforce org. Refresh the page. Now let me open the model. Model pop-up open. Now after cancel the model pop-up will be closed and both of the message that is passing from child component below the button will be displayed. So now cancel the model pop-up. You can see both of the message display here. So first message I display. The model pop-up closed successfully. And second message display, welcome to TW3B by Vijay Kumar. So here you can see both message display below the button. If you open the model pop-up, if I want to remove the save button, I want to use only cancel and display the date color. So now go to the child component. This is child component. This is a cancel button. This is save button. So here I am removing the save button. And here I will pass button. I will be change that button class name. So SLDS button neutral to change state of the neutral I will be pass destructive destructive. Now save and deploy once again. So here I remove the save button and change the class name. Go to the Salesforce org, refresh the page. Open the model pop-up. You can see the color of the button change and save button also is deleted. Now after click the button, both of the message that I am sending from child to parent will be displayed below the button. So now let's click cancel button. You can see both of the message that is passing from child to parent display here. So friends, in this lesson we are using same component that is created previous lesson, parent custom LWC and child custom LWC. Remaining are same. Here I am using the detail property in the child component. In the previous lesson we have passed only the event name, but in this lesson we have passed detail, and the detail I am passing object type value. So this message I am passing from child component to parent component. So this message I am declared in the child component and pass it to the parent component here. So keep in mind always, detail is a standard key property of the LWC. So use only detail, not details, not any y, not xyz, anything of the word. Only apply detail. This detail called into the parent of the JavaScript here. Event.detail. This is the name of the object key. So if you passing the key value will be displayed on the parent object. If you passing the key value will be displayed in the HTML here. So below the button I am creating a p, and inside the p tag I am passing the variable that is created in the parent object. So this is a two variable, and these two variable storing data that is coming from the child component. This variable I am passing to the parent component here. So after close the model pop-up, this variable display below the button. So friends, try to do from your side in your personal org. If you getting any kind of issue, please write in comment box. To get more related video of the Salesforce, go to the YouTube, search TW3Wave, then click here, go to the videos, and here you will be get so many live demo example of video. Here I created real time scenario based on working on the office. So here you will be get Salesforce Lightning Aura component, Visual Force page, Salesforce LWC, Lightning Flow Builder, and here so many video you will be get that is working in office in live project. If you subscribe my channel, your project working will be very easy. So friends, like, share and subscribe and support my channel. Thank you so much.